grand rising loves. So, in meditation this morning, I literally feel like I'm gonna vomit right now. So I just, in meditation this morning, I was told by spirit that this is how I have to show up today. And I'm gonna cry. And I always am very obedient, but I feel like I'm gonna vomit right now. Anyhow, this is how I sleep. So, God, let me be able to talk. So I was obedient to listen, to show up, and show my face. But this is very hard for me. So I am doing this. And today the planetary ruling is the sun. And so the sun is in Taurus and I'm a Taurus. And so spirit giving me the direction to show up like this was very difficult. So I know I've shared the last full moon. I was actually in a sweat lodge. Oh, let's see if I can get the words out. And very powerful. I released agony into the fire, and it was very powerful. And in that release, later on that night and then through the next day, I was actually processing a past life where I had committed suicide. And so it's been really intense month of processing that. And so the ancient pain of not being first choice has been a theme that has shown up many lives. And so I always designed, and you can see I'm processing right now. When I'm processing this poison, and my acupuncturist actually even said, Sherry is still holding the poison. So I had actually taken hemlock in that past life. And I could feel all the symptoms again moving through my body. And you can hear it coming through my throat. And so there's quite a few on here that are psychic. You may be able to feel that. It actually feels like stinging nettles in my throat. And it's really intense. But for spirit to tell me to show up like this, without showering first, without even brushing my hair, and not getting dressed, was really intense for me. And thank you, Rachel. Rachel was the person I texted because I was here crying and trying to negotiate with spirit if I could show up maybe a little bit different, like maybe brush my hair. Anyhow, this was how I was told to show up. So what has been coming up in this past month, and the reason why I'm sharing this is because I know I'm not the only one, but in my mind, you're gonna have to watch the video from the very beginning to see why I'm crying. Anyway, so in my mind, I'm very aware of when ego shows up for me, and it designed this woman that I thought would be first choice. And so 2 weeks ago, I had seen her as a waitress, and I told my friend, beautiful soul sister of mine who I was eating with, I said, that's her. She's first choice. And it turned out that this first choice was actually a 26-year-old who had had 6 augmentation surgeries at 26. And not only that, but she was a waitress without medical insurance, single mom of a 3-year-old boy. And so she had a choice to go have the surgeries in Mexico because it was way cheaper, and a choice between 2 doctors, one that would charge $6,000 and one that would charge only $3,000. But he had had patients die on him. And this is what really had me fucking twisted, is that she chose the doctor who had had patients die on him to save that extra $3,000 as a single mother of a 3-year-old child. And here I was thinking that she would be the choice over me any day, right? Because I knew spiritually, there's no one like me, and intellectually, personality, right? And I'm always teaching, there's no one like you. We are as unique as our fingerprints. And but here I thought, this is what society and what media says would be chosen over me. She's the more perfect choice. And also the lesser Eve, right? So she's easy. She's not gonna challenge anyone, and she's not gonna be difficult. She would be the first choice. And she had such a beautiful heart, but was so broken. And it really had me twisted for at least a week, like processing, meeting her and talking to her. At only 26, she had liposuction and a fake booty and fake titties and a tummy tuck and Botox. What the fuck? A 26-year-old getting Botox. And I was thinking, what the fuck is wrong with humanity? Like, it was insanity to me that someone at only 26 would be getting Botox, and she had lip injections. And so I asked her, I said, you know, I'm almost 50. Do you even have any idea what that's going to do to your body when you're 50? Like, what are you going to look like when you're 50? And she said, I have no idea. But I already know that I need to get my lips fixed because they messed up. And I really don't like the back of my thighs because this wasn't right. And I'm thinking, this is insanity. And I felt so, I just wanted to hold her. But really, I wanted to hold myself for how fucked up everything has gotten. And so when that happened, and then I don't know if you saw the picture of Scarlett Johansson being circulated with her man, and it was so pathetic. She's hanging on him and he's literally like over her shoulder checking his phone, like not even engaged or attentive to her. And I was like, oh my God. And it was powerful. Super powerful that the universe brought those situations to me to show me how twisted my own trauma had made my own thought processes. So this morning when spirit in meditation told me to show up like this, this is how I wake up, no makeup, didn't even brush my hair, honestly haven't even brushed my teeth, and I cried and I felt like I wanted to vomit, but I knew if I when I'm obedient, beautiful things happen. And so I'm being obedient to spirit and the direction. Thank you. I'm receiving that. Thank you. Thank you all. So tomorrow being the full moon, I know that this is why this came up and why I'm processing it, but I also know I'm not the only one, because my sisters, Ashe, my sisters also do this to themselves. And here's this poor 26-year-old beautiful open-hearted girl, single mother of a 3-year-old boy, abusing her body. And it was heartbreaking. So I'm showing up like this to tell you, like, I've never had anything done to my body, and you will also never catch me in a gym. I spent a lot of time in my 20s abusing my body, spending a lot of time in the gym and overworking and punishing myself to become something this body can't become. And so I do yoga every morning. I dance every day. I walk, I ride a bike, I hike, I do things that feel fucking good. And that's what we're supposed to be doing. We're not supposed to be abusing ourselves for the attainment of what we think we're supposed to look like, to draw in a partner that, as she said, she's been cheated on multiple times. And I'm thinking, this poor 26-year-old girl going under the knife with the really no idea whether she's gonna come out of it alive or not. Like, she literally said, I told my mom, look, this doctor has had people die on him before, so if I die, like, are you fucking kidding me? Anyhow, it taught me a lot, like processing that past life after the sweat lodge and meeting her, and then seeing that picture of Scarlett Johansson. I'm like, every woman is afflicted with this pain, and the ego of the males has also been so poisoned that they are looking for that woman. And unfortunately, damaged women, and maybe it's the whole like hero complex, like, I'm gonna save her, and you're actually damaging her more. And the whole like trophy wife thing, and it's just sick. Anyhow, I'm feeling less like I want to vomit right now. Thank you. So anyhow, thank you for letting me ramble. Yes, the DNA memory damage is so archaic. It's deep, it's old, and it really needs to be healed. So I always post pictures of myself with no filters, and I've never had any augmentations done to my body, and I will continue to be that way. And I will be 50 in a week, and I'm grateful for my health, and I'm grateful for my heart and my spirit, but this was hard for me to do, I'm not gonna lie. And so anyhow, thank you for sharing your most valuable commodity with me. Spending that currency on me did not go unnoticed, and I appreciate you all. I love you. Right. So the spread for today, I'll get to that. And I do have a giveaway at the end of the video. So if you hang with me through this spread, I do have a giveaway. Thank you, Elizabeth. I love you too. That's true. Thank you. Age is just a number, that's right. Breaking all barriers, thank you. I'm trying to be obedient is what I'm trying to be. Anyhow, the sacred geometry that showed up for today, and I love this, because this also talks about this today's spread, the cohesiveness of today's spread is talking about doing too much. Are you doing too much? Are you working too hard? So the divine doorway, I have heard of colloidal silver and gold water, and I actually do use colloidal silver. I actually have the gold water saved as a bookmark on my browser, but if you want to DM me, let's talk about it. Because I'm curious if you have actually been doing that. And I also use colloidal copper. So the divine doorway talks about you being a portal, your heart being a portal. And if you look, I've always talked about that the Taurus energy that's through the heart, and that you can access your wisdom that was your birthright through that heart space. So the divine doorway actually talks about staying grounded, but entering the space of your heart to elevate your connection with ascended beings, ascended masters, your guides, your angels. What does it say? Ashe, yes, after. That's the exact bookmark that I had, actually. The Forbidden Knowledge Store. That's the exact bookmark. So yes, let's chat. So the divine doorway showed up upright, and it talks about entering that portal of the heart to commune with those higher spirits and ask for help. And it says that's all you need to do is just ask. So if you're feeling uninspired or disconnected or unbalanced, you can always ask to be recalibrated or just ask for a little bit of guidance or support, because that's why they're there. They're not there to be disdaining or overlook our human experience laughing. It's not entertainment for them. Like, they are actually there to be support to us. So the divine doorway calls you to ask for that help, and that's all you need to do is just calm yourself and ask for that help. And so that's the energy with this, also the new deck, to the sea. And this talks about being in the flow, to surrender and just let go. And I talk about this a lot in my spiritual teachings, that when you are not aligned, when you are acting or reacting from the ego, from the programming, it becomes like that Sisyphus effect where you're constantly fighting against the flow. So you're like pushing that boulder up the side of the mountain, and you'll never be able to achieve that apex of meeting that height, the top, because that boulder is just always going to roll down on you. But when you are aligned and you allow spirit to be your guide, and the intuition and all of that support that really is there for us as our birthright, it becomes a flow like the river to the sea. And that's exactly what this card says. Allow yourself to surrender to the divine, and you will flow like the river to the sea. And everyone is a river. No two rivers are the same, but we all flow to the same source in the sea. And so allow yourself to do that. And this is the tool of the day. And I do not have one of those, so take a good look at the stone. It can also be called cross stone. But this says the same exact message. So this is a really cohesive spread and I love it today. And so probably also because of my obedience that I've been gifted this cohesive spread. And so Sterilite talks about support and it says, have you not ever asked for support in order to feel strong, in order to appear like you have your shit together? And it's saying that that's, it actually takes greater courage and strength to ask for help and to be vulnerable and to humble yourself. It takes the greatest level of strength and courage. That's the true warrior spirit, to actually say, I could use a little help here. And so that's the message of Sterilite, that don't feign the strength and suffer. Don't do too much. That it actually takes greater strength to say, come walk this with me. And so Anapusis is the culmination of today's spread, which exactly says, don't work too hard. You're doing far too much and it's not even necessary. That it is your birthright to have the ease of the human path when you allow all of the support that is your birthright to actually do its part. You won't have to do so much and it takes far less effort to be human. That's the spread for today. So the giveaway is, I have for the males, if you do this, this deck. And so these decks have been my tools, so they are used, but they have been charged by me. They've spent time on my altar. They've been used for the spreads. And so that's the Earth Warriors Oracle deck by Alana Fairchild. Very good shape. And for the females, the Isis deck, also by Alana Fairchild. This is my own personal deck. I've never used it for the spreads, but I use it for myself. And so the only things I ask you to do are to share this video, and I feel so sick about that. But Spirit told me to do that because I would rather less people see it. To share this video and to tag me in it. And also to tag at least one person that is not currently following me. And then tomorrow, the full moon, I will actually choose a name from those shares. One female, one male. So thank you. I love you. And I am sorry for any disharmony that I myself have created. Please forgive me. Thank you for this opportunity, and thank you again. I appreciate you for sharing this path with me and also gifting me your presence, your most valuable commodity of your time and your awareness. I love you.